Okay, well, this video is going to go over some basics of binary, decimal, and hexadecimal. And I'll probably carry the hexadecimal over into the second video, but at least I want to cover the basics of binary to decimal conversion in this video. And then we'll talk about the basics of decimal to hexadecimal, and then hexadecimal to binary in the next video. So this will be a two-parter video on this. So first, let's talk about decimal. We need to go back and do some refreshing here, so it makes it easier for me to get it into my head of the numbers here when we go back and talk about decimal first and how decimal was broken down. So let's take the number of 235. If we write that in decimal places, and that's decimal or dec or 10, we count decimal on the 10th place. So we say 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have 10 places here, the dec system, 10 places, and we count when we get to the ninth place or our 10th place, we start back over. So we have our ones, so we have our ones place, we have our tens place, we have our 100s place, we have our 1000 place, and on up. But we're only going to worry about the small ones at this point. So 1, 10, 100s, 1000. So if we have the decimal number of 235, we say that there are two 100s, there are three 10s, and there are five 1s. So if we add that up, we say that there is 5 plus 30, because there's three 10s, plus two 100s, that makes it 200, plus 30, plus 5, which if we add that up, makes that 235. So that's decimal. That's how we count in decimal. It's base 10. It's base 10. What we call base 10. Now, binary works a little bit different. It works the same, but it's base 2. Binary is what we call base 2. We only deal with 1 and 0. So it's either on or it's off. So because we're dealing with electrical signals, and that's what the root of binary goes back to is the electrical signals, and that's what we deal with in networking. We deal with electrical signals, ones and zeros, that go across the network. So at its base level, when we're dealing with networking, we're dealing with binary. We're dealing with binary or ones and zeros. So if we were going to look at binary and we would say that same number of 235, let's scroll back up to our screen up here. And if we were looking at decimal here, and we were saying that decimal is the number 2 would be 10 in binary, because it's 10, because we're looking at our places here, because 2 in decimal would be right here, over here on this side of the chart right here. 2 is our 2, and so we would have a 1 there because that's on, and we have a 0 there because the 1 is off. We only have the number 2, so 1 and 0. So let's go through how I find to add binary up really easily. So let's look at binary. So when we're looking at the binary chart here, and this is what we're looking at right here, we're looking at the binary chart right here, and we're looking at the bit places. And we're only going to carry this up to 8-bit places. Now, just like the places in decimal, you have the ones, tens, thousands. Here you have the different bit places. You have the one place, the two place, the three, the four, the five, the six, the seventh, and the eighth. And obviously these carry on out, but we're only going to deal with eight. Mainly because when we're talking about IPv4 later on in the networking class, or when you d deal with that, IPv4 deals with octets, which octet is eight places in the IPv4 addressing. And so we just deal with, on the binary side, eight places at this point, because once you can understand this level of it, it's easier to carry it on up into higher numbers. Just like when we can add, 10 plus 10, that's 110 and 110, then we have 20. Or if we have a 5 and a 5, that's two 5s and that's 10. And that carries on up into the next place, which make, into the tens place. So when we're dealing with binary, we're dealing with just one place, two places, ones or zeros. So when we're dealing with the mathematics of it, the first place is 1, and that's 2 to the 0th power. 2 to the first power, you know, and then we're dealing with exponents here. And so every time you go up a place in binary, you double it. That's the key to remember here is when we go up into the next area of binary, we double. So we go from 1 to 2 to 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256, 512, 1024, 2048, and on up. You just keep doubling it. So if you just keep doubling that number with binary, it's just going to get larger and larger and larger. And so when we're going to count in binary, what I have found it easiest to do when I don't have a calculator, and I'll show you where to find that on the calculator here in just a few moments, but when I don't have a calculator, what I have found it easy to do is to come in here to and hand write a chart out. And so what I do is I typically, just like my numbers, my places up here, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. It doesn't take a lot to remember how to write that out. So I just come to my place and I write the 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128 to get my 8 places. Now we obviously could keep going up. And just like the chart here, we would just keep doubling. 2 to this 8th power, 2 to the 9th power, 2 to the 10th power. And so, we could go 128, 256, 512, 1024, and we could keep going up. Now, like I said, we're only going to deal with the 128th place or the 8th bit at this point. So, because we're going to use that same number, we're going to use the same decimal number of 235. So, let's take the decimal number of 235, and let's convert that to binary. So, what the easy way to do this is to say 235 decimal on this chart here, it's smaller than 256, but it's larger than 128. So if we put that 235 and we say that is going to be one bit place on the 128, that's going to be one bit place on the 128. So that's going to leave us with a remainder of 107. So that's going to leave us, so we've subtracted out the 128, and that leaves us a remainder of 107. And 107 is larger than the 64th place, so that gives us another bit place. So we have that turned on. And that then takes us, and then we say that's a bit place turned on, and then we minus that 64 place out of there. And that leaves us with 43. And that's larger than the 32. So we're going to bring the 32 and we're going to subtract that out. But we have a bit place here. And that leaves us with 11. So we have 11 remaining, but 11 is smaller than 16, so we do not have a bit place there, but it's larger than 8, so we are going to put a bit place there, and we're going to subtract that out, which is going to leave us with a remainder of 3. And 3 is smaller than 4, so we're not going to have a bit place there, but it's larger than 2, so we're going to have a bit place there. And it's an odd number, so it's always going to end up with a bit place in the 1, because we have a remainder of 1 on there. So what we have done is we've said the 256 is equal to 1111010111. Now, if we want to proof that, what I want to show you is on the Windows side. If you have a Linux computer, you can. There's computers that do the binary conversion as well. But on the Windows side, Windows 7, Windows 8, even back to Windows XP, you can go in here to Windows and go to the calculator. Open up your Windows calculator, and if you change your view to Programmer or do the Alt 3, see we can come in here on our decimal number here, and we can type in 2, and I typed in 256 up here. I just realized I'd made a mistake right there, and that is not 256 right there. That was our 235. So for those of you that were watching that, okay. So on our calculator here, I just wanted to correct that just in case anybody was seeing that and it was bugging you. On the calculator here, if we change the view to Programmer, what that's going to do is allow us to do the conversion from hexadecimal to binary to octagon. We can base 8, base 2, base 16. But in this case, we're going to put in 235, and we're going to select the bin number here, which is binary, and that's going to proof that we have 1101011. Now, if that binary number, if there's leading zeros out here, we never put leading zeros in a binary number. We just assume that those get dropped off. So when we're doing binary conversion to decimal number, we just drop those off. So let's minimize that, and let's do another quick number here. Let's say that we do this number right here. Let's say that we do 1011011. Let's convert that number from decimal, and let me just erase all this out here. We're just gonna move this real quick. And let's say that we're going to convert that to decimal. So converting from binary to decimal is the same way. You have your chart here. And on this place, we're going to add each one of these, just like we converted from decimal to binary, that each number we had a bit place, we added that number or subtracted that number. Well, when we're converting back, you just add those numbers back in. So we have 128, no 64, but we have a 32. We have a 16. We have a 2. And we have a 1. And so what we do on the binary from binary to decimal number, we just take those numbers and we say that's 138 plus 32 plus 16 plus 2 plus 1. And if you do the math on here, that's 10, 16, 17, 18, 19 there. And then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 179. And it's as easy as that. And if we wanted to proof that, we would just come back over here. If we wanted to proof that, we would delete those out, and we would say 10110011, and we convert that back to decimal, and that would give us our 179. So if you're going to do very basic binary to decimal and decimal to binary numbers, this is the way you do it on the chart. You can also do it the mathematical way, and there's other videos out there and other methods that show you how to do it based upon the exponents. I just wanted to show you my simple way on how to convert decimal to binary and binary to decimal and back and forth. And of course, if you get hung up, you can always come out here to the Windows calculator, and it will also show you how to do that, or it'll help you proof it to make sure you're on the right path. So give me shoot me an email or send me an email if you have any questions.